Hello there, you're watching Proactive London, and joining us today is Dominic White here from 8 Capital Partners. So a warm welcome back. And today we're discussing financial services disruption, something you specialise in. So what does financial services disruption, what does it mean, Dominic?
Hi, Katie. Thanks for calling me in. Well, disruption to start with is when an established incumbent business is being challenged by new entrants into a market who are often cheaper, often better, often and nearly always using technology to disrupt a business model. We've seen it in hotels with Airbnb. We've seen it in taxi services with people like Uber. We've seen it in movies and movie rental with people like Netflix taking away the entire market from Blockbuster. We haven't seen this really happen yet in the financial services sector. So we still have a lot of high cost, relatively low quality services, which are often slow and inefficient, with thousands of branches of banks and hundreds of thousands of people working there. So we have a situation that a market in financial services where the fixed cost of many of the traditional entities is 3, 4, 5, even 10 times higher than the costs of the new entrants into the market. And when you have something like that happening, it is absolutely ripe for disruption. Clearly, we've seen a little bit of disruption already with the challenger banks. They've done a fantastic job of digitizing some financial services, and things have got better and easier to access and cheaper and certainly faster than operating through many of the branches. But we believe this is only the very, very start of the disruption in financial services. And we believe what we're about to see is a big move from a transition from the centralized middleman economy to the decentralized service economy, which is something we believe is going on right now. And it will mean that banking, borrowing, lending, trading will get a lot more quicker, easier and cheaper for everybody. So that's what we think is coming in financial services.
Mm-hmm. And how is decentralized finance part of this disruption?
Well, decentralized finance it takes out the middleman from the financial services sector. Right now, we have a centralized finance system where we have a middleman, which is often banks, sitting between trades and sitting between the capital and the customer. With decentralized finance, we remove that middleman. So there is no one between the capital and the customer. They lend and borrow directly from and to each other and trade directly between themselves, which means you have a much more efficient, cheaper, and quicker system.
What are some of the benefits of DeFi?
I think one of the key benefits is the introduction of massive competition into the financial service sector. As these decentralized finance companies come along, there's already $100 billion, by the way, in decentralized finance right now. As these come along, they will inevitably take a business away from the major banks, who will have to react by providing better, quicker, faster services through the use of technology. And the second thing is it enables the underserved to be better served. I think there are two underserved areas. One is the SMEs, the small, medium-sized enterprises, who are often, their risk is not priced well by banks, so they're often either not given loans or they're extremely expensive. And the second part of the underserved part of the market is the global population of 2 billion or more, 30% of the global population, who don't have bank accounts because it's not worth the banking sector giving the accounts because it's too expensive for them to be provided at around $100 a year. So those people through decentralized finance can access potentially bank accounts because it costs pennies or cents to provide those accounts through decentralized finance.
And lastly, why is 8 Capital? Why are you interested?
Why are we interested? Because we're a financial services investor, and we're more and more investing in operating business and certainly technology around financial services. So when we see the coming together of a global, enormous market such as financial services, coming together of that with exponential technologies such as AI, such as decentralized finance, all at the same time, all at the same moment, there's clearly an enormous opportunity to invest in products that cross those two areas. So 8 Capital clearly is very interested because that's right in the middle of what it does. We're very interested in the SME part in particular, and the other underserved sector I talked about in particular. And it's something that I personally am interested in. I'll personally be putting more money into 8 Capital to back this strategy.
Sounds good. Well, thank you very much indeed. That's Dominic White there from 8 Capital Partners discussing financial services disruption here on Proactive.
Thank you.